back with The Pulse. I'm Maryam Nemazee in London. So the power of Israel's big corporations coming under focus now. At the moment, some 20 families control 25 of the listed companies on the Israeli stock exchange. The government wants to increase competition by diluting their influence. And here to tell us what that means for the stock market and indeed foreign investment is Zach Herzog, head of international sales at Psagot Investment House. Lovely to have you with us. And so I suppose the question is whether or not this is going to be a good thing for the Israeli economy and for foreign investment.
Well, Maryam, good morning. It is certainly going to be a good thing. At least that's the hope of Prime Minister Netanyahu and his financial cohorts, both in the finance ministry and the Bank of Israel. This commission has been spoken about for several years, but really just got off the ground to do some significant legwork since this past summer's social protests here in Israel against high cost of living and the centralization of power in the hands of the few, as you alluded to. So there are many possible outcomes. One thing is that we must be sure to remind our viewers and investors that the recommendations that have been made to Prime Minister Netanyahu are at this stage needing to pass both his governing coalition and following that legislation in the Knesset. So there is a chance that the lobbyists and the influence peddlers in Jerusalem will try and water down the recommendations that have been made so far.
And so what is it, is that something that you would view as a risk? Because of course there have been widespread protests in Israel, haven't there, and a call for social and economic reform. So if this new regulation does indeed end up being watered down or perhaps even thrown out altogether because of the powerful lobbyists, is that something that would have an adverse effect?
Yes, I think it would, and there are several reasons for that. But I think that what's more likely to happen, given that this upcoming 2012 is likely to be an election year with scheduled Israeli parliamentary elections at the beginning of 2013 and the potential for those to be moved forward, I think you will see the government pass the recommendations on to the Knesset, and there will be the political force of both the Prime Minister and the Finance Minister, as well as the governing coalition, to try and bring those recommendations to legislation before the summer. The Knesset does go on vacation at the end of July through the Jewish holidays in October. So we do expect to see legislation passed in some form or another. And obviously, from a public perspective, the hope is that the recommendations will be passed in a way that is as close to their current form as possible.
And speaking about the bigger issue there, you have an election coming up. What about other problems facing the market right now? Volumes are down. Local institutions have been diversifying assets. How have geopolitical tensions been influencing the level of investment at home?
Well, it's certainly a very salient point. There has been a steady decline in trading volumes in Tel Aviv over the past 6 months and prior to that as well. And at the current time, I think it would be naive and ignorant to say that geopolitical concerns haven't played any part in that. What's important to remember from the standpoint of international investors is that throughout the past 10 years, Israel's market has had a very impressive return, and that has included some very periods of very high conflict, such as the Second Lebanon War, which happened in the summer of 2006. And while the knee-jerk reaction to markets during times of conflict is often steep declines, following those periods, relative calm does come back, and the Israeli market has proven throughout its recent history that it is somewhat able to perform in a defensive manner and then to recover losses during those periods of conflict.
Well, Zach Herzog, head of international sales at Psagot Investment House, thanks for your time.